Hey everyone, in this video I'll be showing you how to use Gemini AI API for web, that is with HTML and JavaScript as well as React.js, without using any backend code. So we can get the response from Gemini AI API's model without a backend code, and we can call it directly from the front end. So that is what we are going to see. So let's get started. So first thing, just Google Gemini AI API. You'll be getting the first link, build with Gemini API. Click that, and you need to sign in with the Google account over here, and after that just click on get API key in Google AI Studio. You'll be taken to an interface like this. Here you can type your prompt, and if you just run this prompt, you'll be getting a sample response from the model. So you can just play around with it, and to the left we'll be having option called as documentation. Just click that. And in this, to the left, we'll be having getting started tutorials. Just expand this and click on web. So if you scroll down, here it has a caution, okay? Using the Google AI SDK for JavaScript directly from a client-side app is recommended for only prototyping purpose, and it's not for production code. So this is like a warning for us, because we will be hard coding our Gemini AI API in the front end itself, since we don't have any backend over here. And if we move this front-end code to the production, we will be directly exposing our Gemini AI API key, which is highly vulnerable. So this is just for a demo purpose. And it also clearly says here, you can use this SDK if you don't want to work directly with REST APIs or server-side code, and we can directly access the models from our web app itself. And this is how you do it for HTML and for any other JavaScript library. So here is the code. First, let's see how we can do it for HTML, that is the plain HTML. So I'm just having here a normal HTML code over here, just a boilerplate HTML code over here along with a body tag. And this has a paragraph as well as a button, and I'm having an on click for that button. If you click that, it just console logs this. And here is the output. So if I go here, this is the output. If I click this, I'll be getting hello in the output. That's the code. And now let's see how we can add Gemini AI API to it. So I will go to the documentation. I'll just copy this script tag first and inside the body. Okay, so I'll just go here, just paste it over here. The import function, basically we are just importing the generative AI library. And after that, if I go down here, you can see this is the literally the main code. So I will just copy this. And rather than having here the console.log, I'll just remove this, paste the code. So we need to remove the function name that they already have. So I'll just remove this and remove this also, as well as the extra curly bracket. And first thing is, it says error. This should be at the top level, okay? So I'll just cut this and I'll just put it above the function. Yeah, now we are not getting any errors. And it says error for await because we don't have async. So I'll just make this async function. Okay, so simple. I'm just having here two script tags. One is for importing the GenAI library, and another one is for calling the model. So here you can see we are having that code over here, and this is my function. Okay, I'll just align it a bit like this. Yeah, this is better. I'm just importing this, and also we need to have another thing over here, which is this one. We need to have the type module. So just go here and add it over here. Yeah, I think now we are good. We have this, we have this, we have this. Yeah, so this is fine now. And final thing is, we need to have the API key. So for getting the API key, you need to go here and you need to go to get API key. Just click on create API key. And in case if this is enabled for you, just click on this and create an API key. Since I'm already having many projects, I'll just click on this and click on create API key. Copy this and I'll go to my code and just replace this within double quotes. So since we are having here a script tag with type module, now we can't access our hello function directly like this. So for that, we need to have the document.getElementById as well as the event listener for our button. So for doing that, let me just come here inside our second script tag and paste this code. It's going to be document.getElementById, and we need to have our button as my button. So just copy this, and rather than having here on click, let me just remove this fully. It's going to be id equal to this particular text, and here just close this, and we need to have our function name, which is hello. So just go here and type hello. That's it. So this is basically the code now. Yeah, so I'm saving it, and if I go to the output, refresh it, and if I just click on this button, it will take some time for the output to get consoled. Here you can see we are getting the response, and in case if you want this response to appear on the screen, what you can do is just go down here. We can just copy this exact document dot thing, just copy this, go inside the function, and at the end paste it. Rather than getting the button ID, I'm already having here a paragraph tag with ID as display text. So I'll just copy this, put it here, dot, we'll be having the text content, and I'll just assign it to our response. That's it, saving it. So if I go to the same output, and if I just click here, after some time, this original text will be getting changed to our response from Gemini AI API. So here you can see, we are getting the response over here. So this is how you do it in normal HTML and JavaScript. So now let's see for React.js. So same thing, I'm just having the standard demo app of React.js, and I've just added a button over here. If I go to the code, here you can see, I've just added an onClick function, and currently it just has a console.log over here. So for this, in React.js, we need to install a npm package. So if I go to here, the documentation, I'll just copy this and go to the code. It's going to be npm I space and hit enter. That's it, this package has been installed. And if I go to package.json, here you can see we have this package added. That's good. So now again, let's go to the documentation, and we can literally just copy this code again. First thing, this one, and just go here, put it inside my onClick handler. Yeah, and this needs to be async. Okay, like this. Yeah, the error has gone, and we also need to have the import as well as the API key assigned. So import will be coming at the top, and the API key can be inside the functional component like this. Yeah, and to get the API key, I'll just take it from the previous one like this, and just replace this within double quotes, saving it. And yeah, if I go to my output, open the console and click here, here you can see I've got the response. So you can just add it to a useState variable, and you can just display it in the screen. So that's a simple thing, and this is not a standard way how to use it, because we will be exposing our API key if you use this in frontend. Just for a demo purpose, you can just try it out. Okay, always have your API key and this generation code in the backend. So that's the video, guys. Do check the playlist of my channel. Run a lot of videos in programming, AI, OpenAI, API also. So check the playlist, subscribe me. Thanks for watching.